Hello.
Hello.
This is Kirk and Tiffany with Seeking the Glory of God Ministries. And the Lord has told us to redo some of our old words. And this is one of the ones that He wanted us to do.
That's right. It's about holiness. So, are you in Christ? If you are, then your bent is toward holiness. And the Lord really wants you to know that. We're going to read out of 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 13 to 16. It reads, "Therefore, with minds that are fully sober, set your hope on the grace to be brought to you when Jesus Christ is revealed. As obedient children, do not conform to the evil desires you had when you lived in ignorance, but just as He who called you is holy, so be holy in all you do. For it is written, 'Be holy, because I am holy.'" The Lord is saying, when you find your identity in Me, holiness is a default position. Holiness is your bent. And when you fall short, you run back to Me. There's no perfect man except one. So don't look at someone and long for what I've given them. Look to Me for what I have for you. There's no one like you. And there never has been or will be. I love you and have reserved things for you that only you can claim. Look to Me. I am good. Isn't that encouraging? And the Lord says in, He brings us to Luke 3, verse 16, it says about Jesus that He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. And it says in Matthew 3:11, Jesus will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. Mark 1:8, John the Baptist says, "I baptize you with water, but He's coming who will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." And of course, John also says it. So we got all four Gospels. The one you see the Spirit come down on and remain is the one that baptizes with the Holy Spirit. All talking about Jesus, right? And what the Lord wants us to know, that besides Jesus is the baptizer of the Holy Spirit, is that holiness comes by the Holy Spirit and not another way. You can't have holiness without the Holy Spirit. And so also the holy wisdom of God comes by the Holy Spirit. 1 Corinthians 2, 14 and 15 says, "The person without the Spirit does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, but considers them foolishness and cannot understand them because they're discerned only through the Spirit. The person with the Spirit makes judgments about all things, but such a person is not subject to merely human judgments." So, therefore, the Lord says it's not possible to give someone a foundation in Christ, the Spirit of Christ, when they cannot understand the things of the Spirit of God. So remember the first question when we open this video, are you in Christ? If you're not in Christ, you can't have the Holy Spirit. And so the things of the Spirit are foolishness to those who don't have the Spirit. Consider Nicodemus when he and Jesus were talking together and Jesus told him, "You must be born again." And Nicodemus was like, "So I need to enter into my mother's womb a second time?" He totally did not understand because it was a thing of the Spirit that Jesus was talking to him about. And then Jesus goes on to say that those who have the Spirit are like the wind that is blown here and there. You hear the sound of it. You don't know where it's coming from, where it's going. And that's how people of the Spirit are. They, to the outside world, they look like fools a lot of times. But to those of us with the Spirit, we get excited when we see somebody of the Holy Spirit following the Holy Spirit, because we recognize it as acts of faith. To other people, they're like, "What are they doing?" And because they're looking at it with their intellect instead of with the Spirit. But the Lord says that faith requires no understanding, meaning your intellectual understanding isn't necessary and in fact is a hindrance to following the Holy Spirit. So when we look at Jesus and see how He lived, we see that He angered those who were religious. They were using their intellect. They were not of the Spirit. So like He healed on the Sabbath. What else did He do on the Sabbath? He ate grain out of the field or whatever. And what we're seeing is that Jesus was different than the religious leaders of his time. And so when you follow the Holy Spirit, you'll be set apart as something different than what other people are acting like. Because we're not merely sinners saved by grace. We're born again. We've been given the mind of Christ. It's different for us, and it should look different to other people. We're partakers of the divine nature. We're the righteousness of God in Christ. Holiness is in you when you have the Holy Spirit. So when the Lord is talking about being holy, you can't be holy without the Holy Spirit. And you have to have the Holy Spirit, or when you have the Holy Spirit, you'll be following his voice. And the Holy Spirit says he brings to us what Jesus says. Therefore, whatever is the mind of Christ, that's what he's speaking to us. He's declaring that to you. And if you don't have the Holy Spirit, that's who you need. That's who you need to be holy. That's who you need to make it in these end times days. That's who you want. He conforms you into the image of Christ.
Yeah, Paul said he didn't come with wise words of men. He came with the Holy Spirit and power. Mm. And that's what we're really looking for. Power. You know, the first covenant didn't work because men were weak. Mm-hmm. They could not follow the law the way the Father wanted them to follow it. Yeah. So he gave us a helper because we need it.
Yes.
And he gives us the power to become holy because we're in Christ. We are, just as the first part of this word said, is that our bent is righteousness because we have the Holy Spirit. I mean, that kind of makes sense, I guess. Holy Spirit in us, righteousness. Yeah.
Right. So how do you not sin? Is it because you put up a bunch of guardrails?
No. It's that your bent is to follow the Holy Spirit.
And I was looking for the power. You were talking about the power.
Yes.
The power to do what is right mm-hmm. comes from the Holy Spirit. I mean, before you had the Holy Spirit, you could try all you wanted to not do the bad things, and you couldn't stop mm-hmm. yourself. But with the Holy Spirit, that changed.
And it's a different... There's like... When we talk about holiness, too, there's a couple of things I think we need to talk about, because holiness, if we're in Christ, that's just a prerequisite. We've accepted Christ. We've been baptized in the Holy Spirit. So now when the Father looks at us, he sees those who are holy. Mm-hmm. He calls us holy. If we sin, and we look at on ourselves, we look at ourselves instead of looking at what the Lord is saying, then we see sin and we call ourselves sinners. But that's a lie, because it can't be that the Father is not speaking the truth. He sees us as holy, so we should agree with him. No matter what your heart is saying to you, the Father knows better. First John, I think, speaks to this. The whole chapter is really good about holiness, but it does speak of that. It talks about how sometimes our heart condemns us, but the Father says that because we're in Christ, we're holy. Well, how can that be? Well, the fifth chapter of 2 Corinthians talks about that in verse 21, where it says, he made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Well, that's how God sees us then. He sees us equally righteous as he is, mm-hmm. which is really amazing and kind of strange when you when you first start thinking about it.
Right.
But when you know that Christ became sin for you, took care of your sin problem, took sin off the table for you, then you can understand how the Father's plan has actually worked out. Jesus actually accomplished what he came to do. he destroyed the works of the devil in us.
That's right. So. That's right. And holiness isn't just a state of not being in sin. I mean, you are holy through the Holy Spirit, but holiness is also power. I mean, the Holy Spirit comes with power.
Mm-hmm.
And that power, the writer of Hebrews talks about Jesus, and it says the power of an endless life. It is an endless life because of his holiness, because he was perfect. He was mm-hmm. totally sinless. And how did he do that? He did it through the power of the Holy Spirit in him. But the power of the Holy Spirit doesn't just keep you from doing a bad thing or help you to do what is right. He helps you to walk in power, a supernatural
right.
life,
mm-hmm.
To heal the sick, to raise the dead, to cast out demons, to cleanse the lepers, and everything else Jesus tells you to do. It will all only be able to be done through the power of the Holy Spirit.
Yep.
And
yep.
so, Kirk, would you mind praying for people to be baptized in the Holy Spirit today? If you want the baptism of the Holy Spirit,
mm-hmm.
and you're in Christ, if you're not in Christ, just repent. You'd say, Jesus, I give my life to you. I turn from who I am. I'm yours.
Yep. Amen.
Just repent. All right.
So, you know, Jesus, a lot of times when he was healing people, he would say, well, pick up your mat and go home. These people actually had to do something that required faith in order to receive the healing that he had given them.
Mm-hmm.
And I noticed that a lot of times this is a good thing to do when we baptize in the Holy Spirit as well. So hold your hands up just like this, like you're going to catch something, because you are.
Get ready.
Yeah. And so according to the Gospels, then, that we just looked at, where it talks about Jesus being the baptizer of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, and according to my authority in the kingdom of the Lord, then I release to you the Holy Spirit. He's on you and in you now. In Jesus' name and in his likeness, the power of the Holy Spirit is flowing into you now. You feel it on the top of your head, and you feel it going down the back of your head into your spine. It's a tingling feeling right there now. And you have received the Holy Spirit. Now, according to Jesus and doing something, start speaking in tongues.
Amen.
Start to just speak in tongues. I'm going to start. And as I start speaking in tongues, all you have to do is speak in a language that's not one that you know.
Amen.
So
just by faith.
Just by faith, start making a noise and let the Holy Spirit carry that along. So here we go. Ishwa laksa mekanasa lahakna sikansala washikanzisi masikanasa halalabasha makanahasa mahakana jisi shikansila wahasha. Keep right on going. Keep right on speaking. If it's the same word over and over, that's fine. If you're getting a couple of words, that's great. He'll increase your vocabulary in the Spirit as you do, as you speak the language of the Spirit. So that's all we're looking for, just to get a start today,
mm-hmm.
and keep on practicing it. Just go ahead and speak it whenever you feel prompted by the Holy Spirit, whenever you think you should, mm-hmm. go for it.
That's right.
So
it edifies your spirit man, so, and it edifies mm-hmm. your physical man, too.
Yep.
So Jesus loves you. Your bent is holiness
yep.
with the Holy Spirit. That means you're not a sinner saved by grace.
Mm-hmm.
You are the righteousness of God in Christ, and the power of God, the same power that raised Jesus from the dead, lives in you mm-hmm. to live a righteous, holy life, to be powerful for Jesus. Amen.
Amen. And the Holy Spirit said in these end times that he would fall on anyone who desired him.
That's right.
So that's the deal. So Jesus is so good. And he loves you so much that he sent his Spirit to live within you and give you power over every created thing. Amen.
Destiny Road partners with organizations that rescue and give honorable employment to human trafficking victims.
That's right. We sell jewelry, purses, bags, tea, clothing, household items, and much more.
You may also find books by Tiffany and Kirk on Destiny Road or by visiting Amazon.com and searching under Tiffany Root. Thank you, and God bless you.